Welcome back. I am very proud to say that I grew up in the city of Northglenn, and one of my favorite parts is all the fun events we have. So please welcome one of the amazing people who helps put all those on, Mr. Stephen Stokes.
Hello, Stephen. How are you?
I'm great. Thank you.
Have a seat.
Thank you.
Of course. All right, so tell me, what is going on in the event world in Northglenn?
Well, as you know, we've been planning new festivals over the last 3 years.
Yeah, it's like every year there's another one or even two.
Exactly. Yeah. The city council encouraged us to do new events, and this is our third new event in 3 years.
Okay.
Magic Festival, happening August 18th and 19th.
Yep.
At your favorite, E.B. Raines Park.
E.B. Raines Park, yeah.
When we put it together, we weren't entirely sure. I've loved magic my whole life. but we've come together with a great number. David and Lehman, who are on America's Got Talent Season 9, will be playing in our theater on both Friday and Saturday. We have a series of intrigue. It's Friday night, that's a 1920s ball.
Okay.
So adults can come dressed in flapper costumes and tuxedos, think of Great Gatsby style.
Very cool.
And then we'll have card magic and other specialty magic on Friday night.
Exactly.
And then on Saturday, the 19th, is for families. So we have over 25 magicians that'll be performing.
Okay.
And they both do like mentalism and sleight of hand and card magic and kids magic, of course.
Very cool. And so this is not like you just going to a store and getting a magic kit and like saying, come watch me in a park.
Exactly.
This is a full-blown event.
I don't, even though I'm planning a magic festival, I actually don't know any magic tricks. So I'm glad you didn't ask me today.
We should have. We should have.
I have to bring along my magic friend.
I think you might have to disappear now.
only in editing.
So where did the idea and, you know, passion for Magic Fest come from?
Well, I think for Northglenn, even though it's only 12 miles north of Denver, you have to do something unique.
Yeah.
And there isn't another magic festival. The closest one is in Dearborn, Michigan, where Houdini lived and passed away.
Okay.
And so, yeah, of course, it's kind of in his honor.
Yeah.
They do a festival, and there isn't anything else like it in this region. And so I've always had a love of magic. I think a lot of young men and women have enjoyed magic.
Yeah.
And so it was really just out of an idea that I had. And so it's really fun to invite my favorite 5,000 people out to Northglenn's Park, and hopefully my idea will be enough to get them excited to come out. And you know, we're really lucky. There are a lot of magicians in Colorado, and we're bringing in some from LA as well.
Yeah.
And so we're really excited. It's gonna be an action-packed
weekend.
I think
so. Is that the number you guys are expecting? Is like 5,000 people?
That'll be my goal.
Yeah.
Yeah. Friday night will be smaller, 500 to 700 people probably.
Just a small 700 people, you know, nothing big or anything like that.
Well, I know, all the events I plan are, the smallest is 300, and then the largest is 50,000.
That seems to happen in Northglenn. I mean, the first year we had the Food Truck Carnival.
Right, was 20, well, we had about 30,000. We had only expected 10,000, and we had 30,000 show
up. Exactly.
Yeah, it's kind of like inviting 5 people over for dinner and having 50 show up, and then going, oh, gee, how do I handle this?
Throws things off a little bit.
Right, a little bit.
Yeah, exactly. So talk about the Food Truck Carnival. You guys also, that's a newer event.
Right, so that just happened, started in May of last year and continued this year.
Yep.
Last year we had just had 18 food trucks. Because of the number of people we had attend, we increased it to 65 trucks this year.
Yep.
So we had about 25 trucks each day, and we had an attendance of about 50,000.
Okay.
In addition to the food trucks, we also have a hard metal carnival ride, so a traditional carnival company with carousel and that sort, and then also Americana and bluegrass music.
Very cool.
Yeah.
And then also another, I think one of my favorite events, the Pirate Fest.
Yes.
Yes.
So happening September 15, 16 is our Pirate Festival. It's in our third year. So that was the first event I planned when I started the city. It was somebody else's idea, and it was a good one. There are a lot of pirates.
So you said, I guess I'll take someone else's idea.
No. I mean, it's not about my idea or somebody else's. You know, events are about a collaboration of a ton of people's good ideas. But with Pirate Fest, we just hit a really good, you know, there's a lot of people that have interest in cosplay and Comic-Con and those kinds of things. And pirate, there isn't a pirate-specific event.
Right.
You know, you can go to the Renaissance Festival and be involved with medieval times. But if you want just something specific with pirates, you should come to Northglenn.
Exactly. So there's the Pirates Ball on Friday night.
Right. So Pirate Ball is Friday night. That's, again, for adults only. Everybody comes in full costume. I mean, it's a night, really, everybody who's there is in
including costume. Yourself.
Of course.
Yeah.
Of course. I have a Pirates Captain coat. And, in fact, my beard that is growing now is in preparation for my pirate costume in September. So I take
what takes more preparation, the event or your beard?
Definitely the event.
Okay.
Definitely the event. But I do have more products for my beard than I've ever had for my hair.
Oh, very interesting.
I know. It's weird. I don't even have a comb, but I have a beard comb and a mustache comb. Luscious Trimmer. I mean, it's a it's a big deal. I know.
Yeah, all for Pirate Fest.
All for all for Pirate Fest. Exactly. Maybe a little bit for my wife.
And then, and then one last event, yes. Noel Northglenn.
Right, December 1st. Yep. Yeah, December 1st is Noel Northglenn. That's a more traditional, smaller event inside of our rec center. Again, I say small event, it's about 1,000 people, right. Which is the capacity of the venue. And we have an indoor snowball fight. Yep. We do roast marshmallows and outside and do s'mores. We have a carriage that goes around. Of course, we have Santa and Mrs. Claus there. So Mrs. Claus entertains the kids until they get a chance to hang out with Santa and let them let Santa know what they want for Christmas.
Very cool.
And then we have some other kids' activities. And it's just, you know, it's one of those events that's free. And this is true for all of our events. We really want it to be low or no cost.
Right.
And so any event that you come to in Northglenn, you can come and do most of the things for free, and there are a few things to pay for. Noel Northglenn is no different. There's no cost
exactly.
to attend.
And although all these are events are in Northglenn, obviously it's not just Northglenn residents.
Right, right. We probably have at least 50%, Food Truck Carnival even more, probably 70% of the attendee base is not from Northglenn.
Okay.
But all the other events, about 50% Northglenn resident and 50 to 60% from okay. other areas. And we certainly encourage, you know, we want people to come in and see what a great town we have.
Exactly.
And come back in another day when it's not an event day.
So how do you manage all these different events? I would just get like so lost in it, I feel like.
Well, I've been an event planner for 18 years, so certainly it comes with a lot of training and background, but it's really about good timeline management, having a good team in place, and then having just a good plan. And just like your set, I mean, it looks really good on the front, but if you look in the back, you know.
Don't say anything. Don't say anything.
Well, no, I mean, that's part of event,
right,
you know.
Exactly.
It needs to look really, really good for the 2 or the 3 days of the event. And I'm not saying we don't plan good events. It's just that it's different than setting up a town for forever,
right.
You know.
Exactly.
Yeah, so I think really it's just about planning and preparation and taking daily actions.
Okay.
And I think that, you know, in January to May, we don't have any events.
Right.
And it would be super easy to sit around and not do anything.
Yeah.
But every day I don't do something in January as hurting myself.
Yeah.
And, you know, oh my gosh, today my list
That's
is
your justification for getting paid during those months.
I do get paid
year-round.
We
don't have events, but I'm working, I promise.
Well, I know. You know, it's, you know, people that know that I do event planning go, well, what do you do the rest of the year? And it's just such a, you know, hurt to my ego. It takes a lot of work to plan for 50,000 people. You think about a kid's birthday party with 10 people and then extrapolate that to 50,000. There are a lot of details involved.
Exactly.
And then I'm doing 8 events a year.
Yeah.
So, and plus other stuff.
Exactly. So one last question.
Sure.
Do you have any like bucket list events? Like, is there that dream event that you would love to plan?
You know, Magic Festival was one of my bucket list events for sure. And then, gosh, that would be, you know, I've done so many. It's hard to say. Luckily, I'll have to think about that one.
Okay. All right.
Maybe one with, you know, like a $1 million party. You know, I've never done something with.
$1 million party.
I did a big,
like having a budget of $1 million.
Yeah. Like I did a. Well, that's not true. I've done $1 million events. So I guess I checked that off. Got that handled.
Perfect.
Yeah. There you go.
All right. Well, thank you so much for coming on.
Yeah, it was great to be here. Thank you for having me.
Perfect. Thank you.
You're welcome.
All right. Stick around. We'll be right back.